Hello and welcome to John Sewing Solutions. Now I'm going to show you some fabric that is one of the best investments for when you're sewing yourself. This is like a stripy material. It's a shiny, shimmery stripy material, and it's a 58 inch wide stripe of 1 inch in multitude of colors. And to me, this is one of my best investments, because there are so many variations that you can use this stripe type of fabric in. It looks quite offensive if you looked at it directly, and it's a little bit like a multitude of different colors, but they're very vibrant, bright colors, and you know, applied right, they work as a miracle. So in my next demonstration, I'm just going to show you just exactly what I've done with this amazing stripy fabric. I went a little bit berserk when I saw this, and I was so excited. I thought, you know what, this is one of the best investments that a person can make, because if you go out and buy laces and trims, they can cost you a fortune. If you worked out just how many portions of different color stripes you can get out of this fabric, then it's value for money. Now the downside of it is that if you pre-cut all the stripes and if you store them, it frays a lot, and you can end up losing out, because by the time you come back to it, you know, all the threads have frayed, and you know, you're messing around with what color to combine with what color. And I think that's where we lose heart, because if you're like me and you're always on the run and trying to work fast pace, then you're not going to find constructive uses quick enough, and it's going to end up going to waste. But I would suggest investing in perhaps 2.5 yards of this fabric, and the 2.5 yards of fabric, then you safeguard it. For the current outfit that I was making, I used the two color combinations of this hot pink and the silvery color. So what I did was I cut the stripe on the hot silver and the slightly took the purple and cut it on the straight line. The good thing is that because it's in stripes, it's very easy to cut. So I've cut the stripes out, and then the remainder, each section has come out like this big. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold all these. I'm not going to cut the next pieces, because I'm going to end up losing, the threads will start fraying, and until I'm ready to use it for the next section, I'm going to wait. So all the pieces that are this one, I'm not going to use. The 2.5 yard length is that generally a dupatta is 2.5 yards, and that way you won't have any joints in it. So we want to avoid as less joints as possible. So, you know, if you wanted to go more sort of bold, you could use the three colors as well. It works equally fine. It saves on combining ribbons and so on as three color combinations. And it presses out absolutely beautifully. And it looks absolutely amazing. So I will go on to show you a result of one that I have already done. The strips that I cut, so the strips that I cut look something like this, and then I've just folded both the edges over, and it sews very easily and it presses very easily. The only downside is that if you cut it too much in advance, it actually frays a lot, and you will end up losing out on the fabric fraying a lot. So the best idea for this is, we've recently been having this discussion on the forum that storage is a major problem, and what I would do with this is actually fold them neatly, store them in a clear bag, and then store it with my laces, so that the next time I come to use this, I know where it is. If it's in a clear bag, I'll be able to see. So that's just a tip for, you know, they are, because I initially cut smaller pieces, and I had to cut, I used it on the anarkali, so I used several pieces. So that's why you're seeing me with lots of leftovers. And the best thing to do is, until I come up with the next color combination of what I'm going to use, I love the Mendi color. There's quite a few beautiful colors that will go with wonderfully with a lot of the outfits. Now, one of the problems that you actually tend to have is some of these colors are quite hard to get. So, like for instance, for instance, I had this lace, and this is on like a bronzy effect, and I've been going around trying to find a color combination to go with that bronze lace, and I had a difficulty. Now, you could actually go with the lighter version of that, or there may be perhaps another color that will combine nicely with that. So this lace is a must. There is a narrower one available as well, but I found the narrower one slightly more difficult to use. I like the wider one because it's, even if you were using just the 1-inch thin strip, then it would mean cutting in the center of the other two. Those two would get wasted, but you will still get your definite one bold line. So that's just the lace idea for you, trimmings idea for you. If you do, whether you want to order it off us online or if you see it in any store across from where you are, then I would suggest investing in it, and it will be the best investment that you'll make if you are a sewing enthusiast.